Hi guys, my last video for you today is going to be a shoe unboxing. I already featured these in my outfit of the day video from the other day, so I'm sorry for that, but now I'm going to do an unboxing on them so you guys can check them out. These are the Jeffrey Campbell Rodman Spike Wedge Sneakers, and these are really awesome, you guys. I don't know, I like these a lot. They have they have spikes on the outside, but on the inside it's just studs, so you don't, like, hit your shoes on each other. And they have, like, there's, like, snakeskin detailing, and then there's patent leather, and then there's, like, pony hair. So, I think this is real, like, cow hair, you guys, or something. Which is kind of weird. I wasn't sure how I'd feel about hairy shoes, but it's, like, flat, so, and smooth, so you don't really, like, notice it very much. Plus, they just look cool. I don't know. I like the multi-textures of them. They have, like, this V in the back, V cut. And then, like, the long tongue in the front. And they go up. And they make your feet look small because they look like just a flat sneaker. But they actually have a wedge in here. It's actually a pretty high wedge. Probably, like, at least 4 inches. I don't know. But they're actually pretty comfortable. They're not, like, ridiculously hard to walk in or anything. I mean, they're definitely not as comfortable as flats. I'm not going to go that far, but they're not bad either. They're maybe a little bit less uncomfortable than my back-offs. Back-offs are, like, for whatever reason, are, like, the most comfortable, like, wedges ever. Like, you can wear those to the mall and not like, have pain at all. Like, they're, like, flats. These are a little bit, you can feel the wedge a little bit. They're not terrible, though. And I would say I got an 8, and I'm an 8. I would say they run maybe a teeny bit, like, tight or snug, but it's more like a snug fit more than anything, not really too small. On SoulStrike it said they ran a little bit small, and I could have gotten 8.5, but I was kind of worried because I saw reviews on this where people complained that their heel was slipping out of the back because of how low it's cut, so I was like, ugh, I don't want them to, like, be too big and have my heel slipping out, so I got my regular size, and yeah, I didn't experience any problems with my heel slipping out, and I think it's because it was such a snug fit, maybe, I'm not sure, but, it's not uncomfortable. It's not like my toes are smashed in there or anything. Like, it's just if my feet are in there and if I move my toe up, I can feel the top of the shoe or whatever. And I don't know, that's kind of like, I see that as like a tight kind of squeeze, but it's not like uncomfortable. I even wore socks and I didn't have any pain or problems. Usually my toes would hurt if they were too small. So yes, I would say they're true to size. Maybe if you have wide feet, I would size up. If you're like narrow average feet and you're like a very true to your size, rarely ever have to size up, you could probably go your regular size. Because I'm a pretty true 8. I rarely have to size up unless the shoe, like, runs really small or something, like with the JC Play sneakers and stuff like that. For the most part, though, I wear an 8 in everything. Like, unless I know for a fact it runs big or small, I wear an 8. So that's why I got these in an 8. I just went with my gut and was like, you know what, I'm getting an 8. And they fit fine. So yes, sorry I blabbed on for so long. I'm gonna try these on right now. Okay guys, these are the Rodman Spike sneakers. Yeah, they're definitely easy to walk in. If you're not good with heels, I'd recommend something like this because there's like, yeah, you can't become unbalanced at all. Like, they're really, really comfy, and I don't know, I just like these because they're really fun, and they have, like, a chunky look to them, and they just look cute and, like, sporty and chunky and fun all at the same time. So yeah, I actually got those on Karmaloop, so they were on sale for like $145, I think, which I know is still a lot, but I was kind of like on a spending spree and I didn't give a shit, so I grabbed them anyway, because I wanted them. I don't know if they're still on there, they might be, they only had a few sizes left, I know, and I'm going to show you guys the other little thing I got in Karmaloop. Only a few sizes left, and I don't know if they're gonna go lower in price or not. I was gonna wait for them to go lower in price, but there was only 3 sizes left, so I was like, screw it, and I just bought them. Anyway, the other item I got off Karmaloop was just a little small thing that I've been wanting to order off there for a while, but I never made a Karmaloop order. So I got this little, it's called the Bonehead comb, and I figure I can use it to tease my little, you know, hair poof, because I don't have a comb right now. I gave mine away to my friend, and then I, like, never bought a new one. So yes, this is the Bonehead comb, and it's a freaking dinosaur comb. Come on, guys, you gotta admit, that's freaking the cutest thing ever. It's so cool. I love dinosaurs, and I just thought this was so neat. And it was like $5, so that's on Karmaloop for $5. It's like the Fred Bonehead comb, so if you guys want to check that out, you can. I was looking at other stuff on there the other day. There's this one place, what is it called? Oh, like OS Accessories. And they had all these really cool, like, chokers and, like, bone necklaces and stuff. And they had a freaking choker that's, like, a patent leather choker. And it has, like, lobster claws on it. It's the craziest thing I've ever seen. So maybe you guys should go check that out just to look at how, like, absurd it is. I don't know. I just thought it was really funky and weird. And I was like, oh, my God, like, lobster claws on your neck. Like, I don't know. I thought it was crazy. But yeah, that's what I saw that when I was like looking at this. But isn't this cute? Look how cute it is. Oh my gosh. I just thought that was like neat little novelty thing to have in your bathroom. I don't know. This is the kind of things I like, guys, okay? I'm weird. Anyway, that was my shoe unboxing video. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. I'll keep making the videos if you keep watching them. Follow me on Instagram. My name is Stephanie Shopaholic if you want to check that out. I think I linked it on my channel page now, but I'm not sure. If not, I will link it below, hopefully, when I upload this, if I'm not too lazy or I forget. Anyway, I know I still have to do a Black Milk collection video, and I want to do an updated shoe collection, but I have so many freaking shoes, so I don't know how I would throw them all into one video. YouTube's still not letting me upload videos over 10 minutes. It's pissing me off. They told me I could upload videos up to 20, but they're not letting me, so I don't know what's going on. And I have to do Black Milk collection, a shoe collection, and then I have to do a cat suit styling video, and I have some other video. I just want to do more styling videos for you guys, but like, I'm so absent-minded, and I get all like distracted, and I just forget to do stuff. You know what I mean? So like, I'm sorry. I'm not mean to be a jerk. I just like forget. So if you keep reminding me, I'll like hopefully get around to it eventually. Just don't hate me for it. And yeah. Just know, like, I mean, it's not, it doesn't take a long time to film stuff, but, like, pulling out my whole Black Milk collection and, like, filming it, you know what I mean? It's kind of time-consuming, so I definitely have to be in the mood to do it, and it has to be on a day where I have a lot of free time, whereas usually I just don't have a lot of free time. I usually work, like, 10:30 to 7, and my dad gets home at 8, so I don't like to film after he's here, so it kind of sucks, you know what I mean? Like, I get home, and I want to unwind for an hour. I don't really want to be filming videos, so I don't know. Today I don't work till 2, I work 2 to 10 tonight, so, yeah, I don't know. And then tomorrow I'm probably going to be working all day again, so I don't know what I'm doing. But yeah, I suck. I need to make more videos for you guys. Anyway, I will talk to you guys later. Thank you, bye.